Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Good evening, everybody. May the peace of God flow all over upon the sinful world. Let us worship and praise Him. Lord, open our lips that we may glorify and praise Your name. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We listen to the ancient hymn, Hail, Gladdening Light. Confess our sins as we pray. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, in penitence we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have left undone. For the sake of your Son, Christ our Lord, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and keep us in eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Our reading this evening is from the Gospel according to St. Mark, chapter 8, and I read the first 10 verses. In those days when again, a great crowd had gathered, and they had nothing to eat, Jesus called his disciples to him and said to them, I have compassion on the crowd, because they have been with me now 3 days and have nothing to eat. And if I send them away hungry to their homes, they will faint on the way, and some of them have come a long way. And his disciples answered him, How can one feed these men with bread here in the desert? And he asked them, How many loaves have you? They said, 7. And he commanded the crowd to sit on the ground. And he took the 7 loaves, and having given thanks, he broke it and gave them to his disciples to set before the Lord, and to set before the people. And they set them before the crowd. And they had a few small fish, and having blessed them, he commanded that these also should be set before them. And they ate and were satisfied. And they took up the broken pieces left over, 7 baskets full. And there were about 4,000 people. And he sent them away. And immediately he got into the boat with his disciples. And they went to the district of Dalmanutha. Here ends the reading. And he sent them away. And the comfort that we have in this reading is that he did not send them away empty. He provided them with food for the journey, and after spending 3 days with them, providing them with food for the spirit, food for the bounty of the soul. In these days, we have been reminded very much of the mortality of the body. And I've been speaking to quite a few people in the last week or so about the fact that those who have died with the consequence of COVID-19, the bodies are then often required or kept outside the church, and then at the end of the service, the clergy person would go out and do the committal, the sprinkling of the coffin with the water as a sign and a reminder of our baptism, and then also the incense, a reminder that God is present in all things and under all circumstances. And in some instances, the one that I officiated at St. Philip's, the undertaker had not understood that the body need not be present. And often we take comfort these days when we say, it is only the body. And yet the body is important. We see here the body that was spent 3 days in the company of Jesus. And the body was fed, and it was fed from the provision from the hands of Jesus. He had blessed it, the food, and he gave it to people to eat. The body is significant because by feeding the body, Jesus had also preceded 3 days of feeding the soul. And the soul resides in the body. The body is the physical address of the soul. And so we should not take too lightly. It's a false distinction, really, between body and soul, because the quality of the soul nurtures the health of the body, and there's a dialectic between the two, between body and soul. And so let us hold on to how important the body is, that it is the temple of the Holy Spirit, and two coexist. And so today we say with delight, and he sent them away after 3 days of companionship, after 3 days of blessing them. There is this Eucharistic moment where he takes the bread and blesses it, takes the fish and blesses it, and then only do they leave and they go their separate ways. Let us pray as we say the baptismal creed. I believe and trust in God the Father who made the world. I believe and trust in his Son Jesus Christ who redeemed humankind. I believe and trust in his Holy Spirit who gives life to the people of God. I believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father in heaven, Hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Make our hearts clean, O God, and renew a right spirit within us. And Father, in this evening hour, as we seek the replenishing of body, as we anticipate a night of rest and of restoration, as we recline in our bodies, we pray this night for those who are struggling to breathe, struggling to eke out some comfort from this night, from this day. We pray that you will be with those in spirit, those who mourn, those who grieve, those who lament the muchness of what life has brought into them in the form of sadness, and in all that takes us along the path of the destitute. And yet, Lord, we thank you for those who come into our lives with loaves of generosity, with fish of kindness that provides for our daily needs in whatever form that is restorative. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Merciful Lord, you are the only giver of pardon and peace. Cleanse us, your faithful people, from our sins, that we may serve you with a quiet mind through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Eternal God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsel, and just works proceed, give your servants that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey your commandments, and that free from the fear of our enemies, we may pass our time in rest and quietness through the merits of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Lighten our darkness, Lord, and by your great mercy defend us in all perils and dangers of the night, for the love of your only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all forever. Amen. Friends, before we go our separate ways, may I just remind you that as of today, we are able to, as churches and as religious institutions, to resume the acts of in-person public worship. And that also applies to our cathedral. For with immediate effect of this coming Sunday, our Eucharist will be at 9:30. By now, many of you would have received a letter from the office informing you again of the necessity of registering. We will have place for 40 persons to register. And then in the course of next week, I will be issuing a letter that gives us a greater idea of the Lenten program, the services and other initiatives around Lent that we will be embarking on. So please look out for that, but I do ask that you try your utmost, those of you who are able to attend, that you try your utmost to register by Thursday. It makes the work of the office staff, which is only really Megan and Zuleka, It makes it easier for them if you register earlier because there are other admin activities, phone calls that they have to look after, and other queries concerning ministry at the cathedral they need to follow up. And so today being Tuesday, by Wednesday, if you can get your name in, and the sooner the better. And then if you have not received an email by today, it could mean that your name is not, that we do not have your email, or we might have an old email address. Please do contact the office so that we can update our information. If you are pretty certain that your name is not on our database, I do encourage you to contact the office and communicate that information. Good night, beloved. See you.